At first glance, this looks like a pretty trivial problem. Usually a simple extrude from the top and a cut from the side should be able to produce this shape. But if you take a closer look at the third picture, you can see that the top face is slightly concave. In this workflow, I'm actually going to begin by assuming that this face is flat and work from there. First, create an extrude using this sketch on the top plane. This is just a cuboid with two of its sides slightly tapered. Use this sketch on the right plane to create a cut. So we have created a general shape without the fillets. In my first attempt at creating the concave face, I tried using a swept cut. Create a sketch on this front face. Sketch a three-point arc that joins to these two corners. Project the top edge to close out the profile. Bring back the previous sketch that we used to create a side cut. Go to Create, Sweep. Select this as a profile. Make sure that the Chain option is selected. Click on the selection box for the path, and select this path. We want the profile to remain vertical as it traverses along the path. So set orientation to parallel. Let's go ahead and add in the fillets. If we compare this to the pictures in the Reddit post, I will say that this is a pretty good representation. But there are two problems. If we compare the solid profile with the side sketch, you can see that with the sweep command, we are not really in control of the side profile. Ideally, we would want a method where we can define a side profile or at least make it as close as possible to the sketch. Also, if you look at the picture, this tip does not curve downwards. So we need a method where we can stop the sweep from propagating all the way to this end. In order to solve these two problems, we will need to turn to a loft. Let's go back to the point before the sweep. We are going to delete the existing top faces. Activate the Surface tab. Control select these faces and press the delete key. Once we do that, the solid body becomes a hollow surface body. We are going to build a new surface body to cover this. Before we can perform the loft, we need to create some guiding profiles in the middle. Create an offset plane from the front plane. And start a sketch on this new plane. We want to create an arc that hangs off these two edges. Go to Create, Projects include intersect, if you hover over the edge, you can see a red dot appear. This is the point where the sketch plane intersects with that edge. Select the edge. Do the same for the opposite side. Create a three-point arc that snaps to these two points. For more guidance, let's create another offset plane from the front, slightly further down. Using the same steps as before, create another arc with the same curvature on this plane. We are going to reuse the sketch on the front face, which was used previously to create the swept cut. Go to Modify, Trim. Select the arc as a trim tool, and select the face to remove. We want to maintain a straight edge here at the back, so we do not need to trim this face. Go to Create, Loft. Select this edge on the front face, followed by the two sketch arcs. Lastly, select this edge on the back face. Check on the Chain Selection option. Click on the Select box for Rails. Select these edges on the side. We have created a watertight hollow surface body. Go to Modify, Stitch. Box select all the surface bodies and stitch them into a solid. From here, we can go ahead and add the fillets. We can see that we have managed to maintain a straight edge here. If you want a more rounded appearance, you can increase the size of the fillet. If we look from the side and show the side sketch, you can see that we are able to have much more control over the side profile. The deviations here are due to the fillets. Lastly, let's take a quick look at using the Replace Face command. If accuracy is not a concern, this can be a quick and easy alternative. Let's go back to the point just before the faces were deleted. I have prepared an arc sketch here. If you look closely at this arc, you can see that parts of it are above the solid body and parts of it are below. I have done this purposely to demonstrate the power of the Replace Face command. Let's sweep this into a surface. Bring back the side sketch. activate the Solid tab. Go to Modify, Replace Face. The source faces are the existing faces that you want to be replaced. Check on the Tangent Chain option and select the existing top faces of the solid body. The target faces are the faces that we wish to emulate. So click on the Select box and select the faces of the surface body. So the Replace Face command has replaced the original top face completely to match the surface body and has even adjusted the side faces accordingly.